Please don't make me wait again.
Hi, we're Pillow Queens.
I'm Cathy.
I'm Sarah.
I'm Rachel.
I'm Pamela.
This is Tara Recommended.
I recited all your lies, repeated moments once or twice.
You're up, McGinnis.
Okay, I'm going first. The record that I have chosen is Whipping Boy, an amazing Irish guitar band. And I feel like a bit of a cheater because I'm really late to the Whipping Boy party, to my shame.
Sounds like a party I want to go to.
Why you're going to get us cancelled? I was told to listen to these guys on so many occasions, and as the girls will confirm, I'm very bad at it. I resist new music.
Mm-hmm. New things generally.
I do. I don't know why. Maybe I just don't trust your guys' music data. Fair. I don't know.
The Kindle. But you wouldn't even get a Kindle.
I like holding things. I like tangible things.
But she's just like, I don't know. I'm like,
I know, but you know, like the magic.
I'll let you have a go on mine later.
Anyways, back to Whipping Boy. We were in... Where did we record our album again?
Donegal, Termin.
With Tommy McLaughlin, and he was like, you're gonna, like, do you love Whipping Boy? I love Whipping Boy. You need to listen to Whipping Boy. And then I listened to them, and they're just, like, the best band in the world. Like, they're actually, like, the best band in the world. So they're, like, I'm sure, I don't know, has everybody heard of Whipping Boy?
I've heard of them. I haven't listened to them.
As the police came around the corner, you didn't have no time to run. And your dad stood up for you, as the judge said you're a fool. And baby sex and flag and shit and women getting stoned. Robbing cars, bars and pubs, robbing.
Their music is so, like, chaotic and, like, poetic and, you know, that rare feeling that you get in your tummy when you, like, love music so much?
You feel sick.
Yeah, like good sick.
Yeah.
And like the feeling of putting your finger in your belly button.
Oh man, it's all.
Could she sit out for this?
Yeah, in the morning.
We have a mic
We usually expect
that tiny microphone offer.
The microphone is too much power.
You're like a whole new person.
He's like, what's his name? Billy on the Streets or something? You're like, for a dollar, name a woman.
Is it like the power of the feeling of putting your finger in your belly button?
Yes. But beautifully emotional, really thought out, complimentary and clashing like guitars. Just, I could not recommend it more.
Wow.
Are you going to listen to it?
I am actually, I'm convinced.
It's a real heavy one, is there more than one?
And also it's the heaviest.
Is it a double record? Oh, it is too.
Yeah, and also I'm just reading here that they have 10 additional B-sides, which I haven't heard.
Ooh.
So...
Do you have a record player?
I sure do. Do we have a vinyl player in the van for our tour?
That'd be strange.
Definitely not.
So, trying to stick it into the CD player.
We might not even have seats in the van.
That's me.
I kind of cheated because I picked a compilation album, but it's an on-purpose compilation album from the movie Licorice Pizza, directed by Paul Thomas Anderson. Now, this film is a bit divisive. Not everyone I spoke to loved it. I adored it. I went to the cinema to see it twice.
Oh.
One time in 35mm and the second time in 70mm. And
I don't even know what that means. What does that mean?
It's just more expansive and it's louder, which means the soundtrack on 70mm was just like right in your face. Absolutely incredible.
Sarah has a master's in film.
I do, yeah. Those are like
if this doesn't work out.
But yeah, to be fair, I could just talk about soundtracks. I just thought it was amazing. It was one of the standout things about the film for me. It features some incredible songs that I should have heard of and hadn't because, as you know, I was late to music generally. Some of these songs, I was like, oh my God, have you ever heard Stumbling In by Susie Quattro? And Cathy's like, yeah, why are you playing that song? That's from so long ago.
I met Susie Quattro. That's why I was like, why have you...
That's brilliant.
Our love is a lie, and so we begin.
It was literally like I heard the song and I was like, this is changing my life. And I feel like that's how I got into music generally, is like through soundtracks, because they were just like, wait a second, what's this? What's this? From like American Pie and stuff, which is why I listened to all that.
Like Dirty Dancing soundtrack.
Dirty Dancing soundtrack,
I've
amazing.
I've never seen the movie, but I had the soundtrack.
Have you seen it now?
No.
Get out there and get a copy of it.
I know the gist.
No, it's so good.
What else is on it?
Great question. I mean, that's the main one. No, A Life on Mars, David Bowie. Like,
gorge.
They just have some really, really beautifully placed songs as well. Actually, what's the one? There's a Wings song on it that's like absolutely amazing. Maybe it's, where is it? Oh yeah.
Paul McCartney and Wings.
Lay Me Roll It, is that what it's called? Mm-hmm. Lay Me Roll It. Anyway, amazing. Also the film's great, but soundtrack, impeccable.
And the artwork is class, isn't it?
Yeah, it's actually really cool. Like, the film is kind of like a TV series or like a series of short films or something. There's just loads of different character narratives going on, but I love it. And also, Alana Haim's acting debut, she's incredible.
Oh, so this is a new film.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, I've seen it.
Superb. Right. Okay. Like, I only went to see it like a month ago.
Right.
Amazing.
You've sold it to me.
I don't have that much to say about mine.
It's all right, babe.
It's Marigold. Oh, excuse me, I have a frog in my throat. It's Marigold by Pinegrove. It's just a lovely album. I love what they do. As everybody knows, I have a penchant for whiny American vocals.
Who doesn't?
Yeah, I don't know. But mostly I love a whiny American female vocal. But this guy, love him. The harmonies, they're gorgeous.
Great guitar player, isn't
great
he?
He's a great guitar player. Great guitar. Really interesting guitar player.
It's just beautiful music. It's just really nice. This album got me through the first lockdown. I brought it for many spins on my bike. Just a very nice album, and I love it.
Have you seen them live?
No, sure, we've been in the pandemic.
Oh, it keeps rescheduling. We all had tickets.
We all had tickets to go.
Do we still have tickets? Or like, has
no, they cancelled it.
Yeah, we were
we got our money back.
Yeah.
So we were going one to see this album live, and then just didn't happen.
What? I said one of us kept that money.
No, you gave me the money back.
Did I? I must have said it to you early on.
You revolutioned it.
You've been very nice.
Yeah, you're very good.
I didn't see it.
I need that back, guys.
Be good to me.
Is it my game?
Yeah, go for it. Tiny microphone.
I actually just have really big hands. So my pick is an extended play by Male, and
is that what EP stands for?
Sorry?
Is that what EP stands for?
Yes. Cool. I feel really smart by saying
yeah.
it. Well, I didn't even think about it. I was like, an extended play.
Wow. Yeah.
That means you're legitimately smart. You didn't even have to think about
done.
It. It just came out ad lib.
Yeah.
But why LP is long play? Yeah. But why extended? Surely should be longer than long, no? Should just be like small play, long play.
Short play, long
short play.
Short
play, SP. The new male SP.
Have a word with them.
I will. Who should I talk to? Tower Records? Somebody?
Anyway, moving on. We're going to talk about my record. Okay, shh. So this is Gender Studies by Male, and I really love it. I love the like beginning of it. It kind of gets me going. Like, it was like ding 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 ding. It's just such a great little like riff coming in. It's so like powerful, but it's also like it's the whole thing is quite like listening to like Laundries on it still gives me kind of goosebumps and stuff. It's very passionate and really like cathartic, and I really love it.
Study my gender, tell me it's not enough. Shout at me in the streets, claim it'll make me tough. Why don't you study my gender? Tell me there's only two. Tell me that it's perfect. It's enough for me.
I think I've only ever seen them play once. And it was a couple of years ago in like what's that venue like above Izakaya?
Tengu?
Must be.
That's such a random. Do they have gigs? I thought it was like
in the back, like in the back room.
No, it was upstairs, somewhere upstairs.
Where's Izakaya again?
Izakaya on the Keys, that one.
The delicious.
Tangy.
Yeah.
I've seen gigs there before.
Yeah, and it was great. And they were supported by Rosa Tralee, the drag queen.
Cool.
Yeah, it was fantastic. Awesome. But I haven't gotten to see them since. And we did have an after party, London after party with them while we were on our last tour. Because we were like ships in the night, because we were both touring at the same time. But we had an official Pillow Queens male after party in some place in London. And it was very, very cool.
That was great. They yeah. DJed.
Did they DJ?
Yeah.
Nobody remembers the night. Now, I have a question.
I do. You don't, though.
I don't know what happened.
They DJed 100%.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, they did. Yeah,
Connie did anyway, for sure.
Have we confirmed how to properly say the name?
Yes.
It's male.
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 But isn't it Grand New Foil?
Yeah, but that's why it's in brackets, that's why it's in brackets. I think.
It makes like sense. It's gender studies. Male.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Cool. Male. Gorgeous artwork.
This is my choice. It's very good. It's only $19.99.
For an extended play.
For an extended... Well, there's loads of songs on it. Short on this. Play. There's like six songs on it.
Yeah. I think they're playing with them.
So that's nearly
That's nearly an album.
That's nearly an LP.
So there you go. That's my choice. It's very early.
That's your excuse.
We have a group pick as well.
Oh, we do, yeah.
We wanted to pick an album that we listened to in the tour van, all of us all together. So we picked Phoebe Bridgers' Punisher. It's very beautiful. It's a very, very beautiful album. It's very emotional.
Another lockdown album that got us through.
Yeah.
Also took it on very many cycles. Just, yeah, she's just a fantastic artist.
We got an early listen to this, didn't we? Shh. No, we're allowed to say that. It was ages ago.
We won't say who, but
no,
yeah.
No, we got an early listen to it, and it was really like the perks of being a musician, just being like, oh my God, are we allowed to listen to this? And just like opening the files, like incognito. Like, don't close your last FM scrobbler in case it loads it online, and just enjoy. Oh, it's amazing.
What's your favourite song on it?
Maybe Graceland 2.
Really?
Yeah, that's, I think it's beautiful.
It is very beautiful.
I think it's really lovely. Like, I love Garden Song, I love Kyoto. Like, I'm. It's
I
a
love
great
Shiny
album.
Satellite.
I See You is lovely.
I See You is gorgeous, yeah. I know the end also very like.
That's
feels
two
like
different it, songs. That's two songs in one.
But it feels like a Pillow Queen song to me. Like it feels like an album closer the way that we do it. That it's just like, yeah. Let's just do everything on this track. And I feel like that's what she did on this track. And it's amazing. And she's very cool.
Very cool.
And she liked our tweet once.
She once liked our tweet.
She followed us on Twitter actually.
What?
Yeah.
What? I thought she just liked it.
Yeah, she followed us on Twitter. She only follows like 700 people, so. Yeah.
You can edit all this out because it makes us
Sarah's
seem very
reaction
weird.
In the van. Oh, I actually thought like something awful had happened. She was like hysterical or like, what's the problem, Sarah? She's like, Phoebe Bridgers liked our tweet.
She liked our tweet that was like, going on tour might set up a TikTok, which was my thing that I was like, guys, I'm going to set up a TikTok. And they were like, please don't. And I was like, no, I'm going to do it. And then tweeted it. And then she liked it. And I was like, I'm setting up a TikTok. It was great.
So she walked outside without an excuse. She could do anything she wants to. She could do whatever she wants.
Her new album comes out on April 1st. It's called Leave the Light On. It's very good. It's on an LP.
It's an LP.
And a CD.
It is actually, yeah, that's the first CD.
Our first
that
CD,
we've had.
Yeah. Mad. People can put it in the car.
You play frisbee with
it. Do cars even have CD players?
Some of them do. Old
they do.
Cars.
Old
no,
cars.
New cars do. My car is a 05 and it doesn't have a CD player.
Does it?
And that's nearly a classic car.
It's because you took
the
radio.
You got the radio put in separate. That's...
No, I bought it with that. There's never CD.
No, you
no,
didn't.
You didn't.
Madigan 100%.
He put in the radio for you.
Be by your side. I want to